Welcome, 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 welcome. Welcome to one and all. Come here, man. Just stand. Stand together with him. Spirit of God, just move. You stand there, somebody stand. Come on, the Spirit of God will come down. He's going to come down on all of them at the same time. Lord Jesus, Father, Lord, we look to the heaven above. Lord Jesus, because your word said, Lord, is there is where, Lord, our redemption cometh from. Lord, as David looked to the hills, Lord, he looked to you, Lord. And Father, I pray, Lord, each and every one of them, send down your power, Lord, upon all. Upon all in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. The word of God says, not by might, not by power, but by spirit, right? But we cannot deny the power of God comes from his spirit. If there is no spirit, there is no power. Because the devil has powers as well, everybody. That's why I said when you go to the cemetery, you see little graves, you see big graves, you see all sorts of graves. Because the devil is no respecter of no man. And God is no respecter of no devil. Amen? That is why we are in the house of God. We gather together as children in the house of God. Looking up to God because he's our master, he's our savior. In the time of trouble, he will be there for us. I don't want to let everybody know we are living in a country, we are living in a time of trouble and turmoil. We are living in a time that it is so uncertain. So that is why people, we have to look to the higher sources. We have to look to God, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. That is why I said we are real people and we are looking up to our real God. What is hard for us, it is easy for him. What is impossible for man is possible for God. And that is why we pay so much our respect unto God. That is why we make time for God. Let me tell you something. If you make time for God, God will make time for you. In the same way we make time to go to the grocery market, the same way we make time to go to work, make time for God, and God will make time for you. You know why the hospital is full and the churches are not full? Because people look up to the doctors more than they look up to God. So they go to the hospital, they complain, there's no bed. But if you go to the church, there's chairs. What you would prefer? Go and lie down in the hospital, bawling and making noise. When the doctors make the wrongs, or if they make the wrongs, come on, then you go to God, and when you go to God, you look up to God, and you say, Lord, you are my protector. Lord, when I'm going to sleep, Lord, you will watch over me. Lord, when I wake up, Lord, you will wake me up. Lord, when I go, and when I come, Lord, you protect me. What would you prefer? The prevention or the cure? I always heard prevention is better than cure. Amen? So there are so many things that we can prevent, everybody. We can prevent our lives ending up in destruction, in turmoil, in misery. We can prevent it by choosing to do what is right. By choosing to make time for God. And God will make time for us. Amen. So love you all. Good morning again. You may have your seats, everybody. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We serve an awesome God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning, good morning. So, The procedure says we only allow him, everybody to use the washroom 5 times, not more than 5 times. Amen, everybody? Only thing 5 times is too less or too much? Too much? How much time will I say? What? Alright, so we don't have much walking up and down. We will be a disciplined people. Amen? I can't understand one people using the washroom 4 or 5 times. We have a tank. Amen? So, but Roger, the man really does sit right by the door to say, here we say, is the toilet, what? The
what?
The what? He said he's the minister of toilet. So he make praise. Somebody say Jesus, come on.
Jesus.
Come on, all the freedom love, say Jesus. I find the more you're happy, is the more the Spirit of God come down, the more the power of God flow through. Is anybody who uses washroom more than 4 times, we call it the ambulance for you. But you have a real serious problem. Right, Roger? Yeah, look, Roger. He says the minister of toilet and affairs. Praise the Lord. God is good. God is good. Well, this morning we are here. Yesterday we had a great time in Mayaro. We was 5 minutes away from the building area. 3 minutes? 2 minutes? 2 minutes if you walk over there. Just like 2 minutes? Melanie, 2 minutes?
Right there.
Right
there. 1 minute
walk from here. But I have so taken up in bringing the word of God. So 1 minute you gotta go and bathe. And church, I'll remember, cleanliness is next to godliness. So we wanted to take the whole church to take a bathe. But then the ladies complained about the makeup and the eyeshadow and the foundation. I went a long time when the house and they had foundation. Now you had ladies putting on foundation. But watch this one, watch my hard boy. That is not true. If you go in Pennywise, where you got it? From a whole building foundation to finish. From pillar to post. God is good. God is good. Amen. God is good. Can I call all the youths up, man? Come on. We got to dance and worship God. We got to praise God. Come on. We don't want to have that trick walk out of that church. We want to be in a living church. Come on, youths. Them youths and them somewhere moving like old people. Boy. Come on, come on. I'm moving like Sister Asina. Come on, come on, come. Come, come, come. Sister Asina and Gail looking like they burned from yesterday. Boy. Oh, watch them fly now, watch.
Anybody
again
born from yesterday?
Mariam, you're born from yesterday. You didn't even do nothing, how you get born? Come here, come, come, come. Come on, you have that energy, you know. She says they're coming back from their church, you know. He coming back from our church, spotless, white and snow, full of energy. Come here, Miel, come. You come. You just want to play, young girl, come. You don't play, young girl. You demonstrate, young girl, come on. Hey, we're going to do surely goodness and mercy shall follow us. We're going to do it in an Indian chutney version. You know chutney? When you spice it up. You buy pulori and you want chutney? As a spice up your mouth. Let's go, Randall. Come on, everybody, take it up. Worship the Lord, come on. Come on.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Goodness and mercy shall do. I'm
Don't drink water there and have there. Amen. You will remain so. You have to get up and let the energy of God take over. So, everybody, we have a shining this morning. I'm sure everybody had a good sleep. Amen. So, time to wake up. I have a fire WD-40 for some of them who are moving rusty, right? If I had an half life spring. I want to fly spring. Bomb spring. Let's go on now.
Come on, 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 come on
Praise the Lord, everybody, give Jesus a big clap. Come on. Come on, a big clap. Clap your hands. Come on. Good man. Hey, let me tell you something. When you put a smile on Jesus' face, he's going to put a smile on your face. When you do something, he will do something. Amen?
Yeah.
We're going to do one more search all over, but you couldn't find none like Jesus. Amen? Let's go. Come on, do it from your heart, do it from your soul, do it all the people. We are not here to put on a show, but we are here to worship and dance, amen? Worship and dance. Come on, everybody. Yeah, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on. Give him your all. And he will give you his all. The highest mountain.
I climbed up to the highest mountain. Looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Went down into the deepest valley. Looked all around, down there, couldn't find nobody.
Yeah.
I went across the deep blue sea. Couldn't find one to convey to the creation of your mercy.
Nobody greater
than Jesus. Nobody greater than you.
Praise the Lord. Thank you very much. Everybody help each other. Come on, come on. Come on, everybody. The Bible says, if you praise God, if you pray, if you worship, if you don't love, you is nothing. Amen. Help each other. Lord, I pray, God, as they worship you with your hands and your feet. Lord, I pray, God, that your Holy Spirit, Lord, you will continue to give them strength, Lord. Lord, you will give them that energy and that love. Lord, so that God, you will bind them in love and unity. Father, this morning, God, as we in church, Lord, we want to put a smile on your face. And Lord, that is what we are doing this morning. So that God, when we do what we have to do, you will do what you have to do. Father, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you very much. Whoa, that beautiful. Isn't that beautiful, everybody? Supposed to be fooling you, because as I always say, when you grow in Christ and when you live in the Spirit and when you acknowledge the Word of God and somebody fool you, I want to believe you have a lot to do with that, because you know your Word. You know your Word. The devil's work is to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But God came that he may give life and give it more abundantly. So we have to be spiritually minded. Our eyes need to be open. Our ears need to be open. We have to learn to see beyond. Beyond. When you look at a person, look beyond that person. Hear the voice beyond that voice. So this morning, in the Bible, there was a man they called Solomon. And when everybody was asking for wealth and money and all everything, you know what Solomon asked for? Wisdom. I had a friend who was a prison officer, and he told me, did I know? He said it takes any foolish man to make money, but it takes a wise man to spend it. He said anybody can make money, you know, but it takes a wise person to spend it. What I want to say, anybody can go to church, but it takes wise people to walk in the Spirit of God. Anybody here? And I believe the church needs to be educated. The church needs to be educated about what you should look out for and what you should not look out for. If you should go in a church and you don't get in your skin, and a preacher tell you, you are going to take a loan to come and give him money. That is not God, that is the devil. Because I want to be on tape, because I want that message to tape and put it up on Facebook and let everybody hear it. Because which part in the Bible show you that you are the fool and you are the thing for yourself, but you have to go and take a loan to go and pray for a preacher? Which part show you that? Which part in the Bible Jesus ever preached and he said, this is a $500 line, this is a $100 line? I don't even look for prayer. I don't think they will read $5 line. Not too cheap. The Bible never show you that. So when you see that happening, I want to say that is the whole form of the Antichrist on the earth already. And not only on the earth, but in churches. Amen? Everybody? Because the devil, one of his plays, he will choose to go and set up camp. Is it the church? Or they know that? Because people have the idea, well, I'm going in a church and that's supposed to be a holy place. That's supposed to be a place of worship and prayer. But you wouldn't believe. Sometimes in the church are more devils than outside here. No? Everybody here, man? What I'm teaching you, you need to be wise. Not in your own eyes, but be wise in God. Everything you see preach, go in the Word of God and see in line up with the Word of God. I don't only so much, but you ought to make sure and test this word. So this morning, you'll be taught a lot about wisdom. You could be going to church and we could be going to church and we could be very foolish at the same time. You know that? You could have the biggest Bible. You could be going to church how long? But yet, some deceiver coming with sweet tongue, sweet words, and when they don't entice you, they don't seduce you, hey, you say yes, yes, and you raise your hand, and that's what the devil wants you to do. So, people, in the last days that we are living in, which is these days, you have to be wise. You have to have wisdom. And where you get wisdom? You go in Apple grocery, you go in one of these grocery in Trinidad. Where you get wisdom? Wisdom comes only from and through the Spirit of God. Because our God is a spirit. And when we praise God, we must praise God in spirit and in truth. You know something? We are not perfect, but we serve a perfect God. Give him a big clap. Come on. Yeah. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. 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 You know what we're doing? We're going to bust the devil files. Amen? We're going to bust the files. Not everything that glitter is gold. Amen? If Mrs. Mohammed was here this morning, she have a gold teeth and she bought. I'm not talking about that. But what I'm talking about, and it glitter, I am talking about not everybody that present themselves to be of God, they are from God. The Spirit of God have its fruits to back it up. It has the potential to back it up. If you say you carry the Spirit of God, somebody come with that demonic spirit, I would love to see you go and deliver that person. And if you can't deliver that person, you know what? You and that devil's friend. Because if you deliver the person, that devil is going to come against you. Teach him anymore. We're going to have a dance this morning by Steve and Giselle. Steve representing the king. They're going to do it. They're going to do it like they never did it before. And Giselle representing Queen Esther from the Bible. Queen Esther smiling again. Let me look a little one day. Right? See, she's smiling around there.
Yes.
When I watch it in the back of the chair, I guess in front. Okay, turn back. Praise the Lord. I feel Steve blushing more than she. See, be a man, boy, be a man.